So Zach with an MA in Fine Arts and Rivia with an MA in Digital Arts have come together to explore the impact that technology has had in maintaining and affecting the structure of our lives. Perhaps the notion of how something was made will continue to trouble many visual artists in terms of traditions and historical notions of practice. But for tonight, I wish to draw attention to the complex space of relating to work in terms of its visuality within the context of which it exists. As noticed by the artist Esther Rosslyn, using digital technology seems to give potential for creating a different type of relationship between object and viewer. This relationship is perhaps the shifting of the autocratic spaces that many artists may find themselves subjected to when struggling to find that one thing, some locator that frames their work as an original and yet contained within a particular frame of reference. Rudyard himself believes that production and meaning comes through production. And for that matter, the limitlessness of his medium that he exploits, the found image, the sound, and the video, is in a constant cycle of generating meaning. This short film is a splicing together of the work of avant-garde artist Maya Deren and sound artist Janet Cardiff in an attempt to address notions of mass consumption, external and internal stimuli as they link to visuals and sound and hope that meaning arises within these spaces. In observing the film, one is faced with the brutal reality of that which is liminal, that which is continuously bringing us back to the point of conscious awareness. In referring to his own work, Rudyard speaks of notions that challenge authenticity and authorship of text, and how in essence, the true root of the word text is defined as that which is woven together in order to bring the viewer closer to the experiential. Suzanne's 20 digitally generated drawings, or prints, address the tensions and complexities in human relationships as they develop between one person to the next, and also how these relationships, the closenesses and the distances, are essentially becoming more and more mediated by the technology that we rely on. Cell phones, BBM, SMS, Twitter, Facebook, and so on. These means by which one aspect of technology governs our lives, the area that is communication, has become so much more of a gauge of our vitality union with others. Other aspects of technology seem to permeate the skin and become embedded in the actual function of the human body. However, not just to be invasive nor destructive, but accommodating and symbiotic, but yet still alienating. However, Suzanne's work is not an indictment on such technologies. Rather, it is a recognition of the evolutionary status that technology grants us as human beings. One can refer to mental images such as those contained in the writing of William S. Burroughs, William Gibson, and more so Kafka. The carefully thought out captions enable the viewer to have some connection to the experience that brought Suzanne to the visual conclusion of the piece, and yet were denied access to the actuality of the conversation she might have had. Each caption reads as a status update on Facebook, or even an editor, or some moment lost. Both artists are reflecting on what it means to be human, to experience and to communicate. I'll end with a quote. At Manfred Moore notes on technology, what fascinates me about machines, or a machine, is the experience of physical and intellectual extension of myself. C. Ten Wayne, congratulations. I hereby declare this.